Hi, in this video I will show you how to do some surface crochet. In this video I will do only straight lines, and well, you have different options how you can do that, and that is what I will tell you in this video. In these examples you can see I did surface crochet on both of them. This is Alize Angora Gold. It's a very nice thin yarn, and it's very drapey even with the surface crochet on it. This is Catania crochet cotton, and well, you see it has a very different look. It's, the stitches are more defined. These stitches are more fuzzy, but very nice. And well, I will tell you what I did. I have made a sample, and with this version I used I anchored my stitches to the post below it. Well, that is not very hard to do, and but you have to be careful where you insert your needle if you want to have straight lines. But you can also do it in another way, and that is just between the post and in the, well, let's say into the space of the squares. And well, I will first show you how to do that. Well, we will start with the first one, and with this surface crochet you put your yarn on the back of your work, and you will pull your yarn through, and you will just make chain stitches. And well, you have to decide if you want to anchor it where you will insert your needle. So be consistent, unless you want to have a kind of wavy line. But if you want to have a straight line and you want to go near this post, you can insert your needle or your hook here, and you pull up the thread like this, and then you will just make chain stitches. Well, one thing I want to advise you, be loose. You don't want to have it pull in. Another advice I want to give you, before you do surface crochet, please block your piece before you do that, so you will have a much more defined look. And well, you can see much better how many chain stitches you need to cross over it. So you can see here, I will just pull up a chain, a loop, and it make a chain stitch, and you have to hook through. So again, I've come to a post, and I will insert my needle through it, and I will get my yarn and pull it through and make a chain stitch. And try to be loose, but you can play with the way how you do this. If you want to make very tight chain stitches, you have to do more to cross over to the other side of a square. So you can play with that. I must say, you also have to find a way that it works the best for you. I like to work sideways, because somehow that works better for me. So try to be consistent in how many stitches you do from one post to the other. And just be consistent in what you do. But you can play with it. There's something that I want to show you. In this piece, I went up, and you can see the legs of the V shape are this way. And when you go down, the legs of the V shape go upside down. It's a choice what you like or what you prefer. If you want to have the legs of the V stitches be the same way on both sides, then you have to go up and then cut off your yarn, and you have to start over again on the bottom. When making a turn here, I will show you how to do that. You can play with it, and you can look how it turns out. I will show you. It depends a little bit how far you have to go to the left in this case. So I did my chains here very close to this post. And do you want to go all the way up to here and all the way up to here and then go down and go back very close to this post? Or do you want to go down or to the left very close here and go down here? So that's a choice that you make. But you can just try and see how it looks, and then you can always say, okay, I did too much, and I have to take a stitch out, or oh, that's not large enough, so I have to add another stitch. Just look, and I won't give you any rules or something like that. Just try it and see how it goes. And I will now go down very close to this post, and I think I will do one more stitch to go down, and then I will insert my hook here. So you can see how it looks. This is more a kind of square like corner, and here you can see I did more kind of more short turn. Okay, this is the version where I anchor my stitches to the posts, and I will have to take it out. And with this yarn, it's very lovely yarn, but when you have to take it out, it's quite fuzzy. Okay, I think I will just tear it apart. Okay, I will show you the other version. I will just leave it here. And that is when I don't anchor my stitches to the post. And in this way, I start differently. I just make a slip knot, and you have the stitch here. And I will pull it through. And instead of inserting my hook here, I will just make chain stitches here. again, you can decide if you want to do very tight stitches or if you want to do more larger chain stitches. So if you pull your yarn up a little bit more, you can have larger stitches. Just play with how many stitches you want to do. So this is kind of more easy because you don't have to insert your needle through the posts, and you can just look where you want to have your stitches. Well, there is one advantage to this this way, because here you can see I can move it over because it's not anchored. And here I did two rows in one one mesh row, and you can pull it apart so you can see the post that is in between it. And in this row I did the same, but here I pushed these together. So I also did two rows in one mesh row, and well, then you get a more more thick line here. As I told you, you can play with the stitches, how large you make them, and you can even do, and I have to get it out again, you can even do very large stitches, so you only have one stitch per square. So I will start the same way again. I make a slip knot and I put it through here. I pull it up. And then you can work through it. And then you just pull your yarn through much longer. And then you have to see how far you go. And if you have done a couple of rows, you kind of get a feeling of how far you have to pull it up. But check every now and then that you don't make them too small. I think this is, well, I should maybe do it a little bit more longer. So if you do it this way, then you will have a totally different, you have another look, more airy look, than if you do two or three chain stitches per square. Of course, here is the same thing. If you go up, your the legs of the V shape will go this way, and if you go down, they go the other way. And there is another thing that you can do with this, and that is work on the posts of the mesh. And well, you can probably guess it. You just insert your hook through several positions in this post. Well, if you crochet, the most easy part to insert your needle is here, and here's where you do the double crochets. And well, if you want to do two chains, then you have to insert your needle kind of halfway. And I will just show you. So I will pick up the fret. So I will do two single crochets and then I will insert my hook halfway and pull it through, and then insert here because that's a very pleasant place to where you can insert your hook, and then you go halfway again and pull the yarn through, and you don't pull the yarn from your post, of course. And with this yarn it's a little bit more harder to do, but okay. But you can do this. Well, I think I will turn it the other way because that's a more pleasant way for me to work, and all these other frets are in the way and I don't have my scissors here. So that's better. You can see here again, insert your needle halfway somewhere. And it really doesn't matter where you stick it, as long as your stitches are approximately the same size. I'm really goofing this up for the video. Okay, well, you get the idea. There are too much yarn ends hanging here that are in my way. Okay, well, it's just what I did at the start, but in this time you do it over the posts all the way. So you can see how that looks. And of course you can see here I did two chain stitches per square. But of course you can also do one large stitch, chain stitch per square, and that just has a different look. There is one thing that I want to tell you. Sometimes you have these projects and then you have made a square or a rectangle, and then later on you have all these rectangles and you have to put them together, and then they want you to have side stitches here, so you do single crochets on the side. And I can't remember where I saw it, but I saw someone do this. So she made these chain stitches over the side first as a base, and then later on she did her single crochets or whatever you need to make over these stitches, because then it's a little bit easier to see and to count where you have to insert your needle to go up again. And I thought it was very, very clever. Well, of course, it makes an extra thickness, so beware of that. But I thought it was very clever to do that. I will show you another example here. Here I did just single rows, but here I worked first in the yellow and then I did this green blue and I worked over the yellow, and then I did this green and I worked over the green blue, and then I did this red over these two. So you can play with it and you can have lots of fun and just see what you like. You can also have totally different yarns. If you have a very fussy yarn with a crochet base yarn like this, you know, just let your imagination go and try everything out what you like. And well, you will be surprised sometimes what you will get. So experiment. And well, in another video, I will show you a little bit more about doing diagonals and waves. And well, then I want to conclude this video with asking you, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And please subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate that. And then I will see you back in another video.